I am Prashant Vishwanath Dhanshetti, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil Engineering from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today I am here to explain about the expression for the crippling load when one end of the column is fixed and other is hinged using Euler's column theory. The learning outcome of today's lecture is student will be able to derive the expression for the column when one of its end is fixed and other is hinged. Now, what is a compression member? The compression member may be a column or a strut depending upon its position, so which is subjected to an axial compressive load. Whereas column is a structural member held vertically with its both ends fixed rigidly subjected to axial compressive load. The failure of column may occur due to direct compressive stress, buckling stress or combined effect. So when the column is a short column, when the length upon least lateral dimension is less than 12, it is treated as a short column and it fails generally by direct compressive stress, which is given by sigma c is equals to pc by a, that is load in compression. And whereas a long column, if length upon least lateral dimension is greater than 12, it is called as a long column, it generally fails by buckling stress, where sigma b is equals to p into e, where small e is the eccentricity divided by section modulus. Whereas in between, the column may fail by the combined effect of direct compressive stress and buckling stress. Sign convention: a moment which will bend the column with its convexity towards the initial position is taken as positive, and the moment which will bend the column with concavity towards the initial position is taken as negative. End condition for column: state the four types of end conditions for the column. Here, pause the video and try to write answer on a paper. The first end condition is both the ends of the columns are hinged. Second is one end is fixed, other end is free. Third is both the ends of the columns are fixed. Fourth is one end is fixed and other is pinned or hinged. The crippling load when one end of the column is fixed and other is hinged. Here you can see a column which is having length L and cross sectional area A, which is fixed at end A and hinged at B, and it is applied with the crippling load P. Due to this crippling load, the column will deflect like this, and as the end A is fixed, there will be a fixed end moment, that is M0, which will try to bring back the slope of the column to 0 at A. Now, to balance this moment M0, we require a force, a horizontal force H, which is shown here. So this is a horizontal force which will counterbalance this moment. Now we will see the section at this point. So let it be at a distance of x from A and the deflection or lateral displacement be y. So the moment at this point will be minus p into y, because this p is now, it is anti-clockwise. So I am taking negative for anti-clockwise, positive for clockwise, and plus h into L minus x. So this horizontal force H into this distance, that is L minus x, and this forms a clockwise moment. So this moment, as mathematically the moment is given by EI d2y by dx square. So equating this moment, we will get EI d2y by dx square is equals to minus P into y plus H into bracket L minus x. Now I will take this minus term on the left hand side, so I will get EI d2y by dx square plus p into y is equals to h into bracket L minus x. Now dividing all by EI, so I will get d2y by dx square plus p upon EI into y is equals to h into bracket L minus x upon EI. Now putting p upon EI is equals to alpha square. Therefore, alpha is equals to under root p by EI. So now putting this alpha square and alpha, I will get this equation, that d2y by dx square plus alpha square into y is equals to h into bracket L minus x upon EI. So the solution of this equation is y is equals to c1 cos alpha x plus c2 sin alpha x plus h into bracket l minus x upon ei alpha square. So again, now putting the value of alpha is equals to under root p by ei, and alpha square is equals to p upon ei. So I will get this equation. So here, cancelling this ei and ei and putting the value of alpha, I will get y is equals to c1 cos into bracket x under root p upon ei plus c2 sin into bracket x under root p upon ei plus h into bracket l minus x upon p. So this we will treat it as equation number 1. Now we know the end condition at A as it is fixed. So at distance x is equals to 0, the deflection is 0, that is y is 0. And also the slope dy by dx is also 0. And when x is equals to L, it is hinged. So there the deflection is again 0. Substituting the value of x is equals to 0, y is equals to 0 in equation number 1, which have just now we have derived. So putting this value x is equals to 0, so this term will get 0. And again, here putting this x is 0, so this term also becomes 0. And here again putting x is equals to 0, so I will get 0 is equals to c1 cos 0 plus c2 sin 0 plus h l upon p. So now cos 0 is 1, sin 0 is 0, so this second term will become 0. So I will get c1 plus h into l upon p is equals to 0. Therefore, c1 is equals to minus h upon p into l. So this we will treat it as equation number 2. So now again, we want the slope to be found out here. So again, I am differentiating this equation number 1. So dy by dx is equals to c1. So cos of this term is minus sin of this term into this value, constant value. So it is c1 into minus 1 sin x under root p upon ei bracket close into under root p by ei plus, now the derivative of sin is cos x, plus c2 cos into bracket x under root p upon ei into root p upon ei minus h upon p. So now here h l upon p, that will be a constant, it will be 0, then minus h into x upon p, so it will be minus h upon p. So now substituting the value of at x is equals to 0 dy by dx is equals to 0 in this equation. So again, now x term, this term will get 0, and again this term will also get 0. So 0 is equals to minus c1 into, so sine of 0 is 0, and plus c2, so this cos of 0 is 1 into under root p upon ei minus h upon p. So 0 is equals to c2 under root p upon ei minus h by p. So I will take on that side. So it will become positive, c2 under root p upon ei is equals to h by p. Therefore, I will get c2 is equals to h upon p under root ei upon p. Now substituting the value of c1 is equals to minus h upon p into l and c2 is equals to h upon p under root ei by p in equation 1. So I will get this equation. This is equation number 1. So now instead of this c1, I will put this value, that is c1, what I have found out. So y is equals to minus h upon p into l cos into bracket x under root p upon ei plus h upon p under root ei by p into sin into bracket x under root p upon ei bracket close plus h upon p into bracket l minus x. Putting the second end condition, y is equals to 0 at x is equals to l in this above third equation. So now substituting this value, y is equals to 0, and instead of x here I am putting the value l, so I am getting this equation. So now putting this value, I will get 0 is equals to minus h upon p into l cos into bracket L under root P upon EI plus H upon P under root EI by P into sine bracket L under root P upon EI plus 0. Now this term will become 0 into 0. This value, it will become 0. So now again I am taking this negative terms on the left hand side. So I will get this H upon P L cos into bracket L under root P upon EI is equals to H upon P under root EI by P into sine L under root P upon EI. So now again I am taking this term on the left hand side. So it will become multiplication. So denominator will go into numerator. So this P, P will get cancelled, H, H will get cancelled. So what I will get is L under root P upon EI cos into bracket L under root P upon EI is equals to sine L under root P upon EI. So now I will bring this cos term here. So it will become in the denominator. So sine upon cos, it will become tan. So L under root P upon EI is equals to tan into bracket L under root P upon EI. The solution of this above equation, the tan value at 4.5 radians, it will be equal to same. That is, so L upon under root P upon EI is equals to 4.5 radians. So now squaring both sides, L square P upon EI is equals to 4.5 square. So it is 20.25. So 20.25 is nearly equal to 2 pi square. So putting that value, I will get P is equals to 2 pi square EI upon L square, which is the crippling load. So these are my references which I have referred. Thank you. Thank you very much for watching my video.